church say amen again.
Amen.
This is 15 Minutes of Heaven, and I'm the Reverend William Ewell. Quick praise report. You know how raspy my voice is. And for years, people have been telling me something's wrong with my voice. So Monday, I went to see the throat, the ear doctor, and he did a borescope and went down into my throat. The praise report came back was, I got a little calluses that's on my vocal cords, and to tone it down, I told him I was a professional speaker. Since that praise report out of the doctor's office, I've learned to discipline and be more quiet. So when I come to speak to y'all and on Sundays and invitations that come in to me, just to hold my voice a little bit. No pilots, no cancer. It was nothing wrong with my voice. My voice supposed to be just the way it is. The title of tonight is What Love Got to Do With It. The three things that'll last forever: faith, hope, and love. And love is the greatest. The four power points that I got for y'all are the four P's tonight. Number one, purpose. What is your purpose in life? Find your purpose in life. Number two, power. Get into the Holy Spirit and learn where your power comes from. Amen. Learn how to use your power. Number three, presence. Always invite God into your presence. This morning about 2:30, I woke up, I had to go to the bathroom. If you're over 50, you know you got to get up and go to the bathroom. I just raised my hands in the air for 5 minutes and praised God. And then I went on to the bathroom. And last but not least, live by God's promises. Don't live on anybody else's promises but God's. Go by God's word. Go by the word of truth. What love got to do with it? Love is the greatest of all. If I could speak in all languages on earth and of the angels, but didn't love others, I would be only making noise. If I had a gift of prophecy and I understood all God's secret plans and possessed all the knowledge, if I had such faith, I could move mountains. But if I didn't love anybody, it would be all for nothing. The scripture can be found in 1 Corinthians 13. That is the scripture tonight. 1 Corinthians 13. At the third voice. If I gave everything I had to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I didn't love others, I gained nothing. If I had all the money in the world and didn't share it with y'all, I got nothing. Me and my wife, what we do at least 3 or 4 times a week, every week, we try to give somebody something. Because your blessings is not what you ask God for. Your blessings come by doing kindness and loving others. Amen?
Amen.
We all the time ask God, give me this, give me that. So we reverse that, and we give stuff away. We got a card ministry. We got a hug ministry. I hug the young lady as she came in today. I greet people at the church because love is the greatest of everything that we can give. Faith, hope, and love. And love is the greatest. If you don't have anything to love in your life, you have nothing. And when Tina Turner made that song, What Love Got to Do With It, I beg to differ. Because if you love someone, you're as happy as you can be. If you show love, you know, in order for a man to have friends, Proverbs 18:24, he must show his
jolly all the time, and you got a song on your tongue, and you got a praise in your mouth.
Yes.
Somebody wants some of that. Because if I see you, I'm going to say, give me some of that. What's your plan?
Yes.
One guy said in the office where we work at, show me what's happy. Why is it so, everybody so happy today? I stood up and said, every day among the living is a good day.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Everybody in the office said, amen, brother. I said, because somebody didn't wake up this morning.
Yes,
somebody wrapped in pain this morning. Somebody wish they could speak this morning, and they can't. Amen?
Amen.
They said, please, it's 6:30 in the morning, and here I go preach.
Yes.
Being God's servant is a critical
day job. Love is patience. Love is not jealousy or boastful or proud or rude. Love do not demand its own way. It's not irreplaceable. It keeps no record of being wrong. Let me say that again, because when I read that, I had to go over that again. It said, it keeps no record of being wrong. See, when you got love in your heart, you don't try to go around and find fault. Mm-hmm. See, because we all got to go before the judgment seat of Christ for our deeds that we have done, whether they're good or bad.
Mm-hmm.
But see, love keeps no record of that.
Right.
Amen? It says it does not rejoice about injustice or rejoice whether the truth wins out. Love never gives up. It never loses faith. Love is always hopeful, endures through every circumstance. So if you're searching for love, try loving yourself. If you're searching for love, tomorrow when you get up in the morning, look in the mirror and tell yourself, I love you.
Amen.
If you're searching for love, try starting right with yourself. Prophecy speaking unknown languages and special knowledge will become useless, but love will last forever.
Yes.
Now knowledge is practical and incomplete, even though the gift of prophecy reveals only part of the whole picture. But when time of perfection comes and these partial things will become useful. When I was a child, I spoke as a child and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now I see things imperfected, like puzzling reflections in a mirror. But I tell y'all about the mirror. My morning, when you get up in the mirror, tell yourself, I love you. Then when you see your significant other or your co-workers or your family members say, I love you, it's catching.
Yeah.
Even the security guard, I told him today, I love you.
Amen.
He said, Pastor, what's your scripture tonight? I said, I love you.
Amen.
And what love got to do with it? Everything. Because if you love yourself, you just like the sun. You beaming off rays.
Yeah.
But when we see everything with perfect clarity, all I know is partial and incomplete. But when I know everything is complete, as God now knows me completely, three things that last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest is love. Let us pray. Father, we thank you tonight for your praise report. Everybody say, I've been bubbling. Because, Father, I know you a healer. The young lady mentioned that she was hurting. I asked her to turn that around and say, I'm healed in Jesus' name. I'm calling on the blood to heal me. When I walked into the doctor, he said, what's wrong, Reverend? I say, nothing. This precautionary. I claimed the victory when I walked in there. I went in there with preaching. I went in there praying.
Yeah.
I pray for everybody under the sound of my voice. I bless the food tonight for the nourishment of our bodies. I pray for my wife, wherever she is on her ministries, visiting the sick and shut in. I ask that you bless this recording, that it go out and do what it has to do, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
What love got to do with it?